Water is our most precious resource. Without it, no person, animal, or plant can survive. This video is all about understanding how your school uses water and how it could perhaps use less. We'll show you how to measure water use, detect leaks, find faulty fixtures, and write a report. The School Water Audit Guide has more information and a series of activities in blue for you to complete. So let's get started by seeing how much water your school uses. Your school's water supply is fitted with a meter, which accurately measures every litre of water used. You'll find yours somewhere on the boundary near the street. Read the numbers from left to right. The black numbers show kilolitres, that's 1,000 litres, and the red numbers show litres. Starting on a Monday morning, take meter readings for 12 days. Record them on the daily water meter reading worksheet. This will show you if there are any leaks in the school. Next, take a look at your school's water bill. Bills are sent every 2 months and tell you how much water the school used and what it cost. Use the water bills to calculate how much water your school uses in a year. If your school reduced water use by 10%, how much money would it save? Your school principal is the person who's responsible for making sure everything runs efficiently. So why not interview them about how water is managed in the school?
How do students learn about water conservation at school?
I think the only way we know about our water use at this school is from the accounts that the registrar has to pay, and we don't even talk about that with the students. Maybe we should. We don't even read the water meter. Maybe we should.
Are the water fixtures in the school water efficient?
Oh, that's a hard one because we're an old school and we have some new sections and we have some old sections. In any of the newer sections of the school, we make sure that we replace any taps with water-efficient taps. We make sure that our water fountains have got spring-loaded return or their push button so that the taps aren't going to be running longer than are necessary. In our toilets, we still have some old toilets that are single flush, but as those toilets break, I make sure that we replace them with dual flush systems.
Now we've worked out how much water your school uses, let's inspect all the places where water is used, both inside and outside. Divide your group into small teams and make sure each team has a water audit kit. Here's what you'll need. Each team uses the school water audit worksheet to record details of all the fixtures in areas where water is used. Use a new worksheet for each new area. Let's get started. A leaking toilet can waste up to 73,000 litres of water a year, so it's important to check every toilet in the school. To see how much water a toilet uses, remove the lid, turn off the water supply valve, and mark the water level. Now flush the toilet using a full flush and refill the cistern to the line with a measuring jug, making a note of the volume of water needed.
3 litres.
Now repeat the measuring for a half flush. When you've finished, reopen the supply valve and put the lid back on. If you think the toilet might be leaking, you can check by using a coloured dye like this. Put the dye into the cistern and leave for 10 minutes, but don't flush. If after 10 minutes or more, you find the water in the bowl is the same colour as the dye, then your toilet is leaking. Did you know one dripping tap can waste up to 10,000 litres of water a year? So your next job is to check every tap in the school. To measure a tap's water flow, turn it on full.
3, 2, 1, go.
And put the measuring jug under the tap for 10 seconds. Turn off the tap and measure the water you've collected.
1.75 litres.
Then multiply this amount by 6 to give you a litre per minute flow rate. Record this on your school water audit worksheet, along with the type of tap and whether it leaks. Then fill out the leaking taps investigations worksheet to work out how much water is wasted if taps are left to drip. Now let's check the drinking fountains. Measure their flow rate, look for leaks, note the types of taps, and record all these details. Watch to see how many times and for how long students use the drinking fountains during the day, and calculate how much water they use. By the way, filling water bottles is a really good way to save water at your fountains. Hand basins and sinks are used for washing hands and cleaning. But how much water are they using? Survey your school to find out. Also, record their flow rates and make sure you check for those leaking taps along the way. Showers can use a lot of water, but exactly how much? To measure a shower's water flow, turn the tap on full and put your measuring jug under the shower head for 10 seconds.
Stop.
Turn off the taps and measure the water you've collected.
1 liter.
Multiply this amount by 6 to give you a litre per minute flow rate. While you're there, make a note of the type of taps and see if there are any leaks. Installing a water-efficient shower head in your showers can halve water use as well as cutting heating costs. Now it's time to take a look outside, at the grounds and gardens. Irrigating ovals, lawns and gardens is where most of your school's water is used. So this is a very important part of your audit. Your best source of information is the ground staff. So have a chat with a gardener about how they manage water use in your school.
Mulch is used on all of the garden beds. We acquire our mulch basically through contacting local contractors who chop down trees in the area, and they drop off their mulch at their own convenience. There are some water-wise plants in the school gardens. The newer plantings that we've been able to have a choice, native plants that are good for this area. They're good for the birds, they're good for the little possums that are around here.
Discuss the grassed and garden areas.
The soil at the school is improved by using wetting agents and, of course, slow-release fertiliser.
Find out when and how they are watered.
We use both skim and bore water at this school. It's mainly the bore water, especially for the larger areas like the oval and the playgrounds. We use skim on the smaller sections of the gardens, especially with the drip systems.
And what sprinkler types are used?
On our school oval, we use these large gear-driven sprinklers, of course, to cover a large area. In the smaller garden beds, we use spray head sprinklers. These are totally adjustable for angle and the amount of water that has to be used.
Then use this information to fill out the irrigation in the school grounds worksheet. If your school has a swimming pool, calculate how much water it contains. An uncovered pool could lose its entire volume of water in 1 year through evaporation. Research the cost of a swimming pool cover and how long it would take to recover the cost through savings on the water bill. By now you'll have a lot of facts and figures about your school's water use. And the next step is to summarise your findings. Using the Taking Action worksheet, collate the results from each team to create a list of leaks, broken or inefficient fixtures, and wasteful practices for the whole school. Now write a report on how much water the school uses, where it's wasting water, and how much money this is costing the school. Suggest ways to reduce water use and set short and long-term targets. Finally, present your report to the school's P&C committee or the principal. Explain in your presentation why it's important to conserve water and remind them how much money the school could save if they took some simple steps. Now you're a lot wiser about water. Don't forget to spread the water-wise message. You can order posters and stickers to put up around the school to act as a reminder. And keep the audit going throughout the year by continuing to read the water meter to keep track of how much water is being used and saved. Good luck running your own water audit.